Hi guys, welcome to Code Artisan Lab. This is video number 13 for Learning Management System in Django with React.js. In our previous video, we have implemented the React Router DOM. With the help of React Router DOM, we have created our application as a single page application. So when we click on this About Us, we are redirected on the About Us page. Okay. So now in this video, what I am going to do, I am going to create dynamic pages with the help of React Router DOM and React.js. Okay, so how we can do that? So and what is the meaning of dynamic pages? So the meaning of dynamic pages means when we click on this specific course, then it will show the particular detail of that course. Okay, so it means our page will be dynamic. It means our page will be our page content will be loaded from our database. Okay, so that is our later we will fetch the data from database, but currently I am going to show you that how we can make our page dynamic. Okay, so we will pass the ID, and then from that when we click on this that page particular, then we will see that ID. Okay, so I am going to implement this flow currently. Okay, later we will implement with the database. Okay, so what we need to do, so this is our home page, and we need this data should be dynamic, and we need to, when we click on this, it should go to the course detail page. Okay, so let's create the course detail page first. So I will create here, let's say course detail.js. okay, and in this I will create function course detail, and simply I will return h1 course detail. Okay, and let's export this so that we can import in any page. So export default, sorry for this interruption. Okay, so export default course detail. Okay, now we will import this in our home page. So let's go to home page and import. I will import from dot, let's say course detail. Okay, and this will be our slash dot slash course detail. Okay, and then we will, okay, actually we don't need to go to the we don't need to import this here, but we should import it in our main.js. okay, because we need to switch course detail page when someone click on that. Okay, I have just tested this, so I'm going to remove this. So I will copy this course detail, and this will be a detail slash course ID. Okay, so this will be your course ID. So, and here in the home page, what I'm going to do, I'm going to simply just implement, let's import the first, let's import link from React Router DOM. Okay, and here we have a link. So I will convert this in a router link, sorry, router link, and this will be 2. Okay, and let's define this detail slash 2, let's say 1. Okay, so see this carefully. So this is our detail slash 1, and here we have defined our routing. Okay, so detail slash course ID. Okay, so this will automatically call this course detail page. Okay, and here what I will do, I will show you that how we can get the ID. Okay, so let's, we have this thing, and when we click on this, it will go to, so why it is not going anywhere? So this is course title. Actually we need to implement this link on image also. Okay, so I will copy this, and here we have link. Okay, so let's refresh the page, and when we click on this here, you can see that course detail. Now we are on course detail. Okay, but we need this ID also. Okay, so that we can implement, so that we can confirm that we are in this page. Okay, so what I will do, how we can get the ID? We know that we have created this course detail page is our single detail, so we know that this is our course detail page. So whatever the ID is, we will redirect on this page. Okay, we will the React.js will load this page. Now why do we need this ID in this component? So we need this ID in this component because when we save the data in the database, later we will do that, but I'm just trying to explain you. So why we need this ID? So when we save the data in database, then with the help of this ID we will get the data from database. Okay, so how we can get this ID in our functional component? So see this. So import use params from React Router DOM. So this is known as hook. So this hook will work. For getting the parameter of the URL. Okay. So this is known as parameter. This is the parameter. Okay. So from before the return, I will just say let ID equal to use params this thing. Okay, and I will show this ID here. Okay, later we will, with the help of this ID, we will get the data later. Okay, so here you can see that we have, so let's say this ID, okay, so this is known as course ID, not this ID. This is actually, we are passing the course ID. Okay, so here you can see that if we pass 2, then it will show 2. If we pass 3, then whatever we pass, it will show here. Okay, so this is the simple video that I'm trying to explain you that how we can make our page dynamic, how we can make our pages dynamic, and how we can pass the ID in the URL, dynamic ID in the URL. Okay, so in our next video, we will create the layout for our course detail page, and we will add some static data so that we can test it properly. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. Please like this video, share this video, and subscribe this channel. Okay, so this is my humble request. If you are really enjoying my video, then please add in the comment section. Okay, and please hit the like button. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.